Okay. I think we can start it. Welcome, everyone. 안녕하세요. My name is Horace Lee, Hao Yang Lee. I'm from China. And today I'm going to introduce a bit of the open infra community in China. I started participated in the China community since 2017, but actually the open infra community in China started before that. It's actually even before 2015, but the earliest photo that I can find in my album is 2015, when the first China OpenStack Kilo Hackathon was held in Shanghai. And the other photo is the Open Infra Days that we organized last year. And we talk about OpenStack Kata containers, how this is used in the China market, how the China companies participated in the community. The whole community was, we have quite a group of lovely organizers, volunteers from China companies that have been participated in the open infra community for years. These people are not just developers, they are also people that have quite a knowledge about open source governance, have quite a knowledge about how to organize event. So this group has also been very dynamic. People left at certain time, and there will be new people, new volunteers join the community. But it's still like the whole volunteer group is getting very active these years and help organize either small scale meetups and Open Infra Days China. How we collaborate? So in China, not sure if everybody aware of, like WeChat is a very popular all-in-one platforms, online communication tools and platforms for people to communicate with. So a lot of things and organizing discussions that happened on WeChat. We do have the WeChat public account that we covers either open source project from open infra community, including OpenStack, Kata containers, Starling X. We also have the foundation WeChat account that will broadcasting and communicating the news strategies, the plans through from the foundation to all the community members in China. Besides that, we also have multiple WeChat groups that either talk about technical collaborations from OpenStack project to Kata containers, as well as the other groups for user cases, discussion, and event planning. And besides the online communication, the offline in-person event, including small-scale meetup, will be happening multiple times a year, all through the China, different cities, different locations, as well as the annual Open Infra Day China, which last year, the Open Infra Day China is a hybrid event, including both in-person event as well as the live streaming. And we attracted over 10,000 community members to attend and understand and communicate with us to learn about the latest technology and what is the latest user cases. With all of this community engagement, as the China community has been started many years ago, and we have quite a large base of community developers that has participated in the upstream development. Now, these years, there are more and more source code and project has been contributed back to the upstream community, including like the Cyborg project from OpenStack, which is a hardware accelerator management component in OpenStack, and the Skyline, it was 2 years ago. It is a modern UI management dashboard for OpenStack, and the Venus project with a log system for OpenStack. Besides the OpenStack, the China community also have actively or dominantly contributed back to the other open infra project, including Kata containers and Computing Force Network. So these are all the projects that shows the China community is really have willingness and actively to collaborate with global community and share our knowledge and experiences back to the global community. And thank you, everyone.
Good morning. My name is Hiroshi from KDDI at Telecommunication in Japan. I am a volunteer of OpenStack user group in Japan. And on behalf of the Japanese committee, I introduced Japan OpenStack user group. Japan OpenStack user group established in 2010. And the chair is Mizuno-san. He is been doing this job for a long time. And currently, our user group has three main activity. First is online communication with mailing list or Slack. And in recent year, we are switching to mailing list to Slack. And the second is organizing a meetup. And lastly, we encourage interaction for between our operators through events. This is a simple start of our community. We have 1,681 mailing list of members, and 254 members are in Slack, and Japan has have some large scale operators such as LY Corp and former Line and Yahoo Japan and NTT Group, GMO Group, and Cyber Agent and KDDI. Many users are using our private cloud or our public cloud provided using OpenStack. Our meetup has reached 49 times, and we had suspended meetup for a while. However, we have restarting the meetup in this year. And now hosting them to roughly every 3 months. And the meetup was held in a hybrid style using Zoom and in-person on-site event with about 100 people attending in this event. Our last 3 meetup, we are focusing on reintroducing the OpenStack. So this is aimed at attracting our beginners. In addition to the meetup, we also hold the Ops workshop. This is a formal style event about once a year. At this event, operators bring their own topics and exchange and to discussion of our their ideas. Finally, let me introduce our annual event conference. Until 2019, we hosted the event called OpenStack Days Tokyo, which focused on operating the OpenStack. Since 2020, we're rebranding in the event name to Cloud Operator Days Tokyo, and expanding the scope of the cover broader range of topics. This event now focuses on infrastructure operating and not just OpenStack. And we, with our OpenStack user group, also support this event. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Abhisap Chuya. I represent the user group, Open Infra user group, Thailand. Oops, okay, gotta go over next. Okay, here we go. For history of this one, Okay, well, I'm going to skip this one. If you want to join, you can scan this QR code. Okay. Okay, our objective for the Open Infra Thailand user group is to build Locky, which is trying to follow the Open Infra Foundation here, and also trying to reskill the people here in Thailand to be very efficient on using OpenStack. And then the last one, our objective is trying to build the self-awareness of sovereignty in Thailand, that if you use open source, you can self-rely on yourself, on self-rely. And that's the key for us trying to build this community here. Okay, we start back this user group since 2016. We have 4 meetups and 1 OpenStack day, you know, which going to be, this is just the picture. We start off at some government office called EGA office, and then we have a meetup at Agoda office. We kind of move around who is using it in Thailand. We try to set up a meetup in that office there. And also this Nipah office, which is the really driver, the Nipah group trying to drive all this user group in Thailand. Okay, here's Khai Di office. And the last one, we have the OpenStack Day in Thailand in the year 2018. Okay, and then the COVID hit, and then we take a leave for 3 years, and then we came back in 2022. Okay, so what we do in 2022 is trying to, you know, do more meetup. You know, this is a timeline for that. So the first one, I mean, this is all 4 of them that we have meets up. You know, first one, more like OpenStack is blooming. We came out of COVID, so we thought, well, maybe we can try to build up something in a way that OpenStack is coming back now. And we do a lot more on that, you know, four more meetup. And then in that year, I think we have a big event called Cloud Native DevOps on open infrastructure. I think we got a good crowd here, so, you know, so a lot of people interested and working on the open infra here. Okay, in 23, we didn't do much of a meetup, but I think you know, our team from Nipah Cloud is setting up. We got 3 presentations in Vancouver here. Lastly, we just want to let the community know that, you know, Nipah Cloud is driving the Open SDN. It's a new open source. It used to be a tungsten fabric, trying to build that part, which is the software-defined network. And I think hopefully that we can encourage some type people to join this group and to help driving this thing. And again, in this summit here, we have 3 presentations that you know, our team is also help build this community as well. And that's it. Thank you.
Okay, so hello everyone. My name is Tuyen. Thank you for having me here to introduce about our community in Vietnam. So as of today, we are 10 years of establishment and we will still continue our journey. So we first started from 3 organizers and now we have 9 organizers in both the south and the north of Vietnam. These are the faces in our current organizing team. So let's talk a little bit about our achievements. So we first started building our community on Facebook, and so far we have over 6,000 members on this channel. And we have been also expanding to the Cloud Native community. Last year, we are honored to be recognized at a Cloud Native community in Vietnam. When we also expanded to the south of Vietnam by organizing offline technical meetups and so on, We also always support the Asia Open Infra community on organizing the event. And within this summit, we support on the process like review and the presentation registrations. And these are the numbers that summarize our 10 years of building the community. These are not large numbers, but we are so proud of what we have done so far. Okay, just 2 weeks ago, we have successfully organized the Open Infra and Cloud Native Day in Vietnam. And we have panel discussions. We have exhibition. We have 18 technical talks in the afternoon. And we have over 700 attendees. So every 2 or 3 months, our community, we organize a offline technical meetups in Hanoi or in Ho Chi Minh City. And thanks to the media support, we appear on some domestic and international newspapers. These are some close partners that have accompanied with us in some recent activities and events. And special thanks to the Open Infra Foundation, the Vietnam Internet Association, and all supporters. Without them, we don't have such success to go this far. So if you you have anything to share with us or you would like to make any collaboration, please contact us by these channels. So thank you so much for listening. Yeah.
Hello everyone, my name is Ari, I'm from Indonesia. Okay, before we talk about the user group, for everyone who doesn't know the Indonesia, we are located in the Southeast Asia, and we are the largest archipelago in the world with the more than 70,000 islands. Yeah, and this is our user group. Maybe we are the very young. We just established in 2018, and we changed our user group name in 2022 for the Open Infra User Group Indonesia. And currently, we have 2,000 plus a member on the meetup.com. Okay, and what we have done in this year, in 2024, we do our first workshop with the title, it's the OpenStack deployment with the Kola Ansible. It's very basic one. And then the another one, we held a regular meetup once every month. And we also do the regular meetup and promoting this event with the title "The Road to the Open Infra Asia Summit." And we promote the event. And then currently, more than 10 people from Indonesia coming to Suwon, South Korea. Okay, and the hard thing for the Indonesia is finding and searching for the speaker to share their activities about the Open Infra. And what we do, we collaborate with the other user group. The first our collaboration with the South Korea. We use the SIMRiat and the YouTube for our meetup. And then we also do with the China user group for the online meetup. And then the last time, we do with the Vietnam also, China, Indonesia, and the South Korea. Okay, actually we have a same event, the annual event like this event, but the last time we do in 2022, collaborate with the Club Native Indonesia. Hopefully next year we can do the annual event like this, so you can come to the Indonesia. And we also celebrate the OpenStack birthday party. I think the last month we do the 14th birthday celebration party in Indonesia. We have a cutie cake. And then other than that, we are also involved and active with the other Open Infra Asia community. Like Rico just engaged to me in 2021. We do the first Open Infradesh Asia is online because and pandemic, and then also in 22. And yeah, I'm so excited. This year we can see each other in the in-person for the first time. And other than that, Indonesia also helped the other Asia community to design the mascot for this year event. A special thanks to the Bayu Aji, is my friend from Yogyakarta, Indonesia. Also the t-shirt is designed by the Indonesia Community User Group. Special thanks to the Fadil. Yeah, that's all. Thank you everyone.
Okay, hello, I'm Sungsu from Open Infra Korea User Group. So I will introduce our user groups to you guys. So our user groups is created in February 2011. So it is only 1 year later when the OpenStack is coming out to the world. So the most activities in our user groups in Facebook. So you can see our Facebook groups in here, and our most of videos like such seminars or study groups are also uploaded in YouTube channels. So for now, I counted our member yesterday. So it is over 7,000 members in our user groups. So this is our organizers. There are about 7 organizers working with us. So they are very good at OpenStack. And the most of activities are same as the other user groups, like a meetup or a conference. But I want to show the most important activities in our user groups. It is a contribution academies. So this program is supported by by Korean government. So to increase to contributing open source to students or the other developers. So we also joined this program, and we encourage the student and the other developers to contributing the OpenStack. This is our mentors. First line of the 4 mentors are very good at OpenStack, and some 2 are the developers and 2 are the operators of OpenStack. So mainly we focus on OpenStack SDK and CLI because it is very easy to learn, and you don't know about the OpenStack. So even if you are not familiar with the OpenStack, you can contribute to the OpenStack SDK because OpenStack SDK is called the OpenStack API with HTTP. So it is very easy. So by contributing to the SDK and CLI, the student and the other developer can learn how the OpenStack works and how the OpenStack operating. And then we build our brand new website. So this is you can see the URL in this slide. So you can see what kind of activities and what is the news from the user groups in this website. And also we built I forgot the special thanks. So special thanks to the Ian to build our brand new website. And then we also built a forum for Korea user groups. So this forum is for sharing the knowledge and know-hows to the community members. So I want to give a special thanks to the Yunsu to build forums. And we need more OpenStack engineers. So there are a lot of demand for OpenStack engineer in South Korea's company, but we don't have much pool of engineers. So as an OpenStack Korea user group site, so we are collaborating with the university or the other companies to get more OpenStack engineers. So for now, we are doing a mentorship program with some company. And then the OpenStack upstream contribution mentorship is also one of these activities. Okay, that's all from our side. So thank you.
And hi, I'm Rico. I'm not going to do a live demo this time at the keynote, but I just want to demo these user groups. So So it's very interesting. At the very first, we don't know each other. We just separately doing ourselves in our own languages, in our own regions, trying to do the things. And I don't know what's wrong with us. We came out with ideas, like we want to do things together. So we started joining each other's sessions. And then we started the Open Info Days Asia. And it's all the way now, like thanks to Korea User Groups, host the very first Open Info Summit Asia. Right, that's how we're, and yeah, we need to give them applause because remember, none of us are native speakers, so we talk English together, each other. So it's like playing a game with a very hard mode, but we achieve the achievement. So please applause again to all the user groups, and thanks for their hard effort.
Thank you.